So Prince Roger Nelson's birthday was 2 days ago. As everybody knows, about back in late April, Prince passed away. You couldn't miss it. It was really huge news. As for me, my whole Prince experience, I did a performance studies class, and I right off the cuff, it was entirely improvised because that's why I wanted my speech to be in. It was my final performance in performance studies, and I gave a completely off-the-cuff improvised Prince eulogy for my final performance. It was, I thought it was pretty good. It was impressive. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to try to somewhat reenact that, or at least remember to the best of my ability what I said then, in order to remember Prince Rogers Nelson on this day, 2 days after his birthday. What would have been his 58th birthday, might I add. So, let me see here. So, by the end of this video, you'll see some footage of people coming all around the world who have placed their little memories and thoughts and art of or what reminded them of Prince on the fence of Paisley Park Studios. So I decided to go check that out for myself, film it. In fact, because it was his birthday, this is the second time that it's decorated like this. And the very moment he died, it was like twice as full. But I thought I just wanted to check it out myself, so I went down to Paisley Park Studios and checked it out for myself. And I used to live 2 miles away from Paisley Park, so I drove by it all the time. Always would go in, never could, until I believe it was the album release of Art's Official Age. I wish I could go get it, but it's over there lodged in my record collection. But it was the album. It was the official album release party of Artificial Age, which was that was around, I think it was 2014 or 2015, I can't remember. But that was the one time I managed to see Prince live. Was so he had a public album release party at Paisley Park. It was open to the public for free. That was the best part. It was for free, so. Is a very impromptu thing. And so when I heard about this, I had to go. And since my mom happens to be a huge Prince fan, I didn't want to leave her out of the mix, so she decided to come along too, and I went to go see this entirely impromptu little set list that he this performance that him and his backing band at the time, Third Eye Girl. They performed like three songs, and even Kendrick Lamar was there. That was a really cool part. But yeah, that's probably the one big memory I have of Prince. And like back when I lived in my old house, so I lived really close to Paisley Park, but he used to even live like literally across the street off from my neighborhood, Long Acres. What's that road called? It's called it Galpin Boulevard. He lived right across that place. He had quite the estate. So in a sense, you could say he's kind of like our indirect neighbor. Like Prince was Minnesota's royalty or whatever. Like, you know how English people are always emulating their royals? Well, Minnesota, we have our royals, and that is Prince Rogers Nelson. And before he passed away, I was a pretty decent fan. I listened to Purple Rain, listened to 1990. I'm talking like whole records, not just the songs here. So, Purple Rain, 1999, Sign of the Times, Sign Peace of the Times. Not sure how it's pronounced. I'm sure it's Sign of the Times, Sign O of the Times, whatever. And Dirty Mind, which is a really underrated masterpiece, in my opinion. So those four records in particular. I listened to some other stuff, but I don't know, like a moderate fan of Prince, but You know, it's just a shame. Like, I mean, like, I knew this was inevitably going to happen. I mean, not like I wasn't expecting him to pass away at 58 due to some sort of drug overdose. So I've heard. I don't know the exact details of that, but I knew he's. I mean, he's an 80s sex icon. Like, he had world fame pretty much for that entire decade, and he just refused to fade away in obscurity, but that's how I remember Prince. That's my memory I thought I'd share with you today. That I managed to see at least one impromptu performance of him at Paisley Park. And to further prove that I live very close to Paisley Park, here's some footage I gathered of people leaving their memories of Prince on the gates of Paisley Park Studios.